Hey everybody, Gina DeLuca here. We are trying something different today. So this might be like my second pour that I did. I believe this was done with PVA. Obviously, it's not one of my favorite pieces, but I think it will serve as a good test piece for block printing. I don't know if this is going to work. I haven't tried it yet. But before I started doing pouring, I've dabbled in many different mediums, stained glass, jewelry. I've done block printing, watercolor. So this is a print that I made. It's my own design. And I'm going to attempt to print it on here. And we were going to see what happens. So what you need to do this is something to print with. I can certainly do a video on how to make one of these if anyone is interested. And you need a brayer. You need some kind of flat surface to spread your ink on. You could also just use a piece of plexiglass, that works as well. And you need some ink. I'm going to attempt something I've never tried before, besides printing on a pour. I'm gonna see if I can mix a little bit of acrylic color in there. Simply because I don't have any metallic colored ink that is available. You can get that, I just don't have any. So, and you don't need a whole lot. That's more than I need, for sure. Oh no. Like the yellow separated a bit. Oh dear. Okay. Well, tis what it is. Let me just get these two incorporated. Hair of this copper. We'll see what happens. So, you know when your ink is ready, when it sounds like bacon. That's what I was told by my block print teacher, Miss Lorraine M. Wald. Little shout out to her. All right. You want to be able to do a test print. It's kind of like making the first pancake or the first crepe. You just want to prime your surface, your print block. Actually, I think I want a little bit more yellow in this. I want a little bit more contrast for that background. Pop to it. Okay. And now the test print. So I will just lay this down. I will take the brayer. Now it's not completely necessary to flip it. You can just lay this down and bray on this. However, I will have to flip this over. All right, the big reveal. So that is the print. And I think that will be a good color. So let's go with it. I would love for this to be in metallics. I just need to get some more ink. Okay. So, here's what I'm going to do. Okay, I'm going to take this and I'm going to center it the best that I can, touch it in the middle, and just drop it. Okay, now for the fun part, actually, I'm going to take a box. To make sure that those edges don't come off, let me slide this to the end of the table so I can grab it from underneath. Okay. That is a horrible noise, and I'm sorry. Okay. Okay, I'm going to flip it back over. Slide it gently. Move my box. And I'm going to peel. Oh, yeah, baby. Yeah. Oh, I dig it. Now I know what to do with all my pores I don't love. So here it is. I mean, obviously, if this were an 8x10 canvas, this would fit on there better. But this was just a test piece. And this was an 11x14. This stuff comes in really big sheets. I got mine from Blick, and I'll see if I can put in a link to it in my Amazon store so you can find it. You know, and these are great because if you learn how to do this, you can print 50 pieces in a couple of hours. You know, the time really goes into the carving. This took me a few hours to carve, but the possibilities are endless. So there's so much that you can do. You could just make strips out of it and use it for borders. You can make something that looks like a frame. So if you have a picture, you can center the picture. Really, there's so much that you can do. And I do see a little bit of sparkle from the copper, so that's cool. But if I had the pure metallic, that would really stand out. So there you have it, something new to try. And if you are interested, I will do a tutorial on how to actually do the lino cut or the block print, the carving and the transferring of the photo or your drawing. And yeah, so hope you learned something. I did. And I hope that y'all enjoyed it. Please like and subscribe and share and all that good stuff. Thank you so very much for watching. And yeah, that's it. Go make some art.